Taking a look at what amounts to be a failed intraday rally by the British pound. The British pound barely succeeded in reversing its three-day losing streak, which it did today. The high today, 124.86, was actually up a little bit more than a third of 1%, 35 basis points to be exact, but fell down to 124.21 and actually finished the New York cash section just below the flat line before reversing in the afternoon in the futures to mildly positive. Since the rotational move up to the 2024 highs, the pound is now down almost 3.5% and on a weekly basis is actually up a few basis points at the midpoint of the week. So we'll have to see how that ends up. Economic data today in the UK, inflation came in higher than expected on a year over year basis. UK inflation for March came in slightly higher at plus 3.2% on the year over year headline figure. The core was up 4.2%. However, it was unchanged on a month over month basis of 0.6%. Now, 0.6% for a month-over-month inflation read is still pretty high. And when you compare that to where the year-over-year and the year-over-year core is, it's nowhere near the Bank of England's 2% target. So it right now still looks like the pound should be gaining strength off of that. But as I just mentioned a little while ago, down 3.5% from that 2024 high. And that likely has a lot to do with the U.S. Now, the U.S. markets are starting to prepare for fewer U.S. rate cuts than had originally been priced in. Jerome Powell yesterday said that rates could stay higher for longer and that would strengthen the dollar and weaken the pound. And while no one is talking about hikes in the U.S., there's now only a 45% chance of one cut, and the market has that price in December. So a stronger dollar is going to lead to a weaker pound, which we had through most of the session today.